You are now can be heard by other people as well.
Let's make sure everybody gets in and we can hit start, and then we'll jump in different channels.
And then pause the game for quite a while. Japan needs a lot of work.
we talked about 5 minutes.
We can't do it for more than that.
And just give a sign when you're done.
5 minutes. Yeah, okay.
Good luck, guys.
All right, let's start.
All right.
So we're keeping it paused. And we will split to our separate channels now. Yep. See you guys.
Going over to Ally. Good. I'll get production.
All right. Yeah, let's set up. So we're going to go for quite an aggressive start here, right?
Yeah.
So, Kane, you're still... did you decide on what you're going to do with China?
Yeah, we're going to leave it alone, I guess.
All right, let's hope that that the 60% chance will actually succeed. Because
that's pretty big. It's really big.
Yeah, 60% is quite big. So we're going to go for quite an aggressive start. Yeah.
No, what I mean is it's pretty big if we get it. If we don't
get
the puppet, it's... You know, pretty screwed. So
yeah, but it's really RNG, awesome basically. As we get. RNG will screw us always. Yeah. So yeah, we're gonna go quite aggressively. We want to go after Poland, and to do that,
if we don't get it, then
we have quite a lot of divisions setting up. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. We want 20 in the first infantry division coming up.
Okay.
I will do some civilian factories assignment, like military factories building.
I don't remember what the other tech was that you wanted to start with.
Let's see.
Oh, doctrine.
Yeah. Yeah, we're going to really, really aggressive here.
Yep, and I will deal with Navy.
Yeah, please do. So how it works is literally if he does something, it will go for me as well. We will both be managing the front lines and stuff like that. It literally is playing the same country with the two people. And it helps a lot because we have to do a lot of micromanagement.
It's strange how RNG dependent Japan is, because if you get the Marco Polo incident going your way and the puppeting going your way, Japan will be a beast. But if you don't, then not so beasty.
So there is a command actually in here, and I will put it in there right now. Multi-Twitch.
At least not for the strategy that we are planning right
so
now.
So that's the link you can follow, and it will pretty much be the entire, like, everybody streaming. My stream will be the front focus, but you can switch it around if you click. So the People's Republic of China joined the Comintern. I will invite you guys as well to the faction.
That will spike. We'll tension so quickly at the start, but whatever.
Yeah, but it's enough. It's underneath 10%.
Yeah, we gotta do it anyway.
The piece of Addis Ababa will drop it a little bit again. So yeah, Germany is set up. Yeah, it's actually a lot easier because when the combat really starts, we have two people who can micromanage, and that's going to make a big difference, especially since the Soviet Union now lost their second player. We were supposed to have two players in the Soviet Union, but due to some unforeseen circumstances, actually one player couldn't make it apparently, and they only have one player. So they will have to do two front war, both with us in Germany and Japan in the East. And that's going to make it so much better for us because, yeah, we are going to play with three players against one. And yeah, the numerical advantage there is really strong. And I'm not sure if Luxembourg will live forever, but maybe. Maybe they will be strong. Now, we're going to go really aggressive, so we don't put any civilian factories in right now. Because we're going to go so aggressive, it's not worth it. Civilian factories we will conquer from other countries, and military factories are pretty much needed right now because we want to push out as many equipment as we can. I haven't really showed you that really yet. So we're going to go with infantry equipment, one line at maximum, towed artillery at two lines, and building just more infantry equipment. Yeah, and support equipment right now, we're not even going to do that right now. We're going to go on for 22 with infantry division. And that's going to be fine because we will have a guy called Gerard von Rundstedt. He has an offensive doctrine.
All right, just hopped into...
All right, we are good as well for unpause when you're ready.
All right, we're good to go. Ready to go.
All right, so we can almost go. I haven't heard from the democracy yet, though.
Give me a sec, though.
So there's not really a
lot. Are you guys almost ready? So can I also almost unpause?
Almost.
Yep. All right. Jump into the Axis Armory when you're ready. So give me a heads up, okay?
All right.
The democracy guys are not ready yet either.
I will leave some tanks and motorized one factory each just to use that.
Sometimes my screen will scroll because. My screen will scroll because I'm tapping over to like the Discord channel. Yes,
I have the old tanks anyway.
Yeah, we're not going to completely abandon the Air Force, but we're just not going to build extra planes. So we still be using them, and we're going to get some extra Air Force when we do the Anschluss. So that's kind of working for us.
Oh, I'm buying tanks from Japan, and I guess. You can send me some oil.
So we're not going to focus on building ships so much either, but that's generally as Germany not a great focus. And the ships that we have will pretty much use to blockade the Baltic Sea. We're going to focus on one sea area. And we'll let Italy do the heavy lifting for the rest. Yeah, you have to be careful with the night body. Usually it's quite aggressive for these kinds of things. And yeah, I mean, that's the true Blitzkrieg, right? Just don't produce it. Conquer it from your enemies. So let's see what the rest is focusing upon with their doctrines. Stalin Constitution. And I have like a...
UK is doing limited rearmament.
I have a check mark sheet to the left of me, so I can see pretty much what focuses they are going for. How about US?
And US is going for VPA. WPA.
Interesting. I kind of would have thought they would go for the Monroe Doctrine. So they're doing a different strategy than I imagined.
They're not rushing Venezuela.
No, apparently.
And PRC has gone straight for political effort.
And you say that we need to build some fighters. I don't think so.
Oh, they would have seen me rushing
but
to China.
But you will see.
They will know what we're doing.
Yeah, I think they want to go for either collectivism.
Popping in. Go ahead and unpause in 30 seconds, all right?
All right, we're going to give it like a minute and then we'll pause.
Okay.
So we don't really have to build the fighters. I think we'll be fine. You will see when we get a little bit further along in the game how we're going to plan this, and it's going to be fine. And for Italy, first they need to do Ethiopia, and then they will do the victory of Ethiopia kind of tech focus tree pretty much. All right, it's been about a minute, I guess. Let's unpause. Let's go. And there we have it. We are going.
We're live and rocking.
Yeah, you guys should have faith.
I had to do in Japan. Holy shit!
It's gonna be really fine. We're gonna do really different tactic than normally.
Yep. It's all done. It's all good to go. Everything is working. Need to split my navies a little bit and then. Be nice.
All right, Ferocious, can you do the navy? We haven't done that yet, I think.
Yeah, I'm just letting them merge.
So if you have the multi-twitch from the night the Moobot link, it should not click it. You should like literally copy and paste it because there's a comma in between somewhere, and that breaks the link. Otherwise, you can go to my YouTube video where I did the announcement for the stream, and you can click the link that is listed over there. So that should also work. I don't know if the rules are updated with the link as well. So I just posted them another time to make it clear. So what we're going to do is, as soon as these guys hit 20% training, we're going to deploy them. And the reason we do that is because for Anschluss, you need to have a certain amount of manpower, and we're going to rush down Anschluss this time. That means rushing down divisions. We need to get that 550,000 manpower. Right now, if every division that we're producing right now would be deployed, we would have 468,000 manpower going for us. And I kind of want to up that a little bit by just pushing them out as soon as possible. We're going to go for a total of 3 runs on our 20 infantry units over here. And the reason why I do that, that will add up to like 60 guys. Later on, I will add another 5, I believe it is, together with the 9 that we get from Austria. It will become an even 100, and I'm a sucker for those kinds of things. Just the nice even numbers. But yeah, we want to be like a hawk, focusing on this. And Ferocean will be focusing on spending our political power when it comes up. And he did our Navy, and he's doing our Air Force, so I can pretty much just focus on this. And this is the kind of things that it really helps, to have an extra streamer there. And I just noticed there is no background music from the game. Let's fix that as well. That sounds much better already. So yeah, things are moving. I didn't miss it. Let's push them out. So the first 2 divisions already went out, and yeah, gonna be updated while we're going. Push more guys out. And around the 17th of, I think, well, yeah, 17th of March, we should be having enough people. Thank you, Martime. I try to be helpful on my YouTube channel as much as possible. Yeah, we shouldn't be having inefficient resources. And keep pushing out more guys. And another way to help reach the 550,000 manpower is to edit our infantry division with another infantry guy. It will increase for every division that we have the manpower requirement by an extra 1,000. So that's going to make things a little bit easier for us as well. Just doing everything we can to reach that 550,000 manpower. Yeah, this is definitely not the standard Germany strat that you're doing. This is a strat that we came up with as a team to shake things up for the multiplayer event. Is this best strat? I'm not sure, but we have some rules as well. So for example, we can't go after the Dutch immediately at the start of the war because we're not allowed to justify a war right now. So it's definitely a good idea to just justify a war to the Dutch, to take their colonies and get the delicious rubber and stuff like that, but we are not allowed to do that right now, so we can't really.
People's Republic is justifying war against Shaanxi.
Yeah, I expect that.
Yeah, that was to be expected.
Because what else is he gonna do?
Yeah.
And then Soviet Union is land leasing him once it starts, because they need that for him to get
They haven't sent their divisions to Ethiopia. I guess they were afraid they will lose them.
Or maybe they just didn't think about it.
Or maybe they didn't want to.
I would want to if I were them.
That's if they want to be hostile to us at the start of the game, right?
But maybe yeah, that is the thing.
They want to indicate that, oh, they just want to be peaceful and, you know, not be
good hostile. Job on Addis Ababa.
It's good timing, yeah.
Yeah, we're going to try and avoid the war with the allies for as long as possible.
Yeah.
The allies, if I could choose, we would just not have a war with the allies. But usually I'm not allowed to choose those kinds of things, so we are a little bit on dependent on them as well. That's weird.
Perfect.
I'm not sure why it's not working
levels,
then.
Three levels.
Maybe I messed up the link somehow, but I don't think so. I tested it before and it was working for me. Sorry guys if that's not working. You could look up Bridger's channel and you'll be able to find it. Yeah, that's kind of a thing that I'm afraid of, that the UK will guarantee Poland. So let's hope that they won't guarantee Poland. That would be the best thing ever for us. I mean, it's possible we have a player in the UK, they might forget. But we wouldn't be the first guy to forget it doing it. I've had that when I played a single player game, like, why am I not at war with Germany right now? Oh, I actually have to manually guarantee Poland. Right, I forgot about that. It's like these small mistakes, but they mean like a lot in the game. I mean, they can make or break a game. If you forgot as the UK to guarantee Poland when Germany did the Danzig War, then, oh yeah, how am I gonna get to war with Germany now? Because you can't justify a war against them. Yeah, exactly, just let's hope they forget. Alright, so we're almost done with our first focus. That's on the 11th of March. And then we probably need a couple more days to actually get to Anschluss. So let's keep focusing on this. This is at 17%. Alright, first focus done. I will update our infantry division.
Oh my goodness, I got lucky with the Chinese border incident. I have extra land now. Sweet.
Good job. Oh, nice. RNG already working our favor.
Yeah, part one of RNG is going Japan's way.
Ferocean, yeah, could you do the... political power, thank you.
X's goes up one.
So we probably need just one more guy and then we'll be able to do Anschluss. And also the divisions are reinforcing
so
with that extra guy.
Well, if part two goes RNG our way, that will be it.
And there it is, Anschluss.
Without captains, that will be the game.
Early civil war. I don't like that.
Wow, March. Okay, that's fine. I've seen it happen in Feb. So
just make sure that the nationalists don't win.
Yeah. So you guys are sending volunteers, right?
I'm not sending anything.
No. Unless they send, I'm not sending squad.
Really? Well, I have
nationalists shouldn't win. Republicans should win.
Since I'm not attacking China, I will be sending them.
You don't have to send anything.
Don't send.
It will spike war tension.
Buff up war tension, and what we want is.
And we don't want the nationalists to win. Republicans should win if I have a choice.
Yeah, but you guys have ways to gain army experience. Now I don't have a way of gaining army experience except training, which is too slow.
Yeah, but we don't want to spike war tension.
It's like 1%.
Yeah, but if the nationalists win, then it will be a large spike, and if the Republicans win, there will be a small spike. And that's the thing.
Alright, okay.
Yeah, I'm sorry, man. I understand it.
I don't have any way of gaining army. That's
me.
Not even an advisor?
Really. Soviets haven't sent any
volunteers
yet.
They have
so
not.
So if they don't, we don't then.
But if
they have sent five.
If they do, we might want to.
Yeah.
Because Italy's fleet
we'll
can't
it.
Get out of the Mediterranean
okay,
if they're
then
not
Then Japan go and send and just, you know, be on the defensive.
Yeah, if the UK guarantees Poland, then we are going to be screwed, but I'm pretty sure that they won't. Because the talk that we're doing about war tension, it's really important. We don't want world tension to reach a certain level, which is too high, and then they will be able to guarantee. But if the world tension stays low,
1.9% threat, so.
Yeah, the problem is though if the nationalist Spain wins. So make sure that you don't win the civil war yet.
Oh, you want to drag it out? Sure.
Drag it out as much as possible. Yeah, which will also give you more army experience.
Yep, that works for me.
Because we want the world tension to be low. You can't guarantee a nation. Guarantee independence as a democratic nation can also only be done when world tension hits 25%. Right now it's not hitting 25% yet. And that's why I'm like, don't finish the civil war. That will cause a world tension spike. We don't want the world tension spike. So right now we're at 918 manpower if everything would be deployed. We will add a couple of extra infantry divisions.
I might not be able to see the volunteer divisions because of being a co-op player. I know that some things aren't shown for that.
Oh really? That's really bad.
Yeah, it's weird. I don't know why.
That sounds like a bug they should address quite soon. It's really important for multiplayer, I think.
Yeah, but they don't care about multiplayer. Multiplayer is a secondary concern.
Yeah, but I think they will care more about multiplayer now.
I wish that was the case.
So let's see what the USSR is up to. Finish 5-year plan. So let's check that off on the list as well. Finishing 5-year plan. The UK is doing what? So Shadow Scheme. Right, and the US is going for Committee on Technocracy. Checked off as well. Alright, I have everything marked down. It looks like the USSR is not expecting much of a war, but just going for economy.
The reason I changed.
Yeah, I came prepared to this game. I checked a lot of things before.
Oh, there
this
we
one.
Go. Now I can see the Japan volunteers and the Russian volunteers.
It's weird that it took so long. Before.
No, because Japan is very far away, so it takes a long time for our units to get there.
I think it's always 2 weeks.
Yeah, and that's indeed the thing. I don't want to spend the political power that much on getting a better war economy going, and the USSR will gain more out of it, so I would like it not to happen. And it looks like the USSR is going quite aggressive in the Spanish Civil War.
So it's just me, which is Soviet enforcement.
Yeah, they're going quite aggressive. You should be able to hold out, though.
Yeah, we should be fine.
Almost, not entirely. I have a large, L-shaped desk. So on one side of the L, I have my setup with two monitors. And on the left side, I have like three pieces of A4 paper, where I have written out the entire focus tree for the USSR, the UK, and the USA. Let's add another 5 divisions here, so that we will have a nice even 100 number. Because I'm a sucker for those kinds of things.
Oh, his tanks have been cut off. GG's.
Kill them. Kill
yeah,
them.
The Soviet Union. Really? You got your tanks cut off. Yeah, first move. His tanks overstretched. Oh, he reinforced it. Yeah, he managed to save them.
Almost.
Yeah. Go finish off.
Well, I mean, you just heard what he said, right? Some of them were already encircled. So, here's to hoping.
I know what you have to hold on for nationalists not to win, and that's basically Barcelona, but I don't know the other way around.
I'm just going to focus on killing units rather than victory points, so...
Yeah, if you can kill USSR units, that will be a massive bonus to us.
Yes, thanks though, I don't have tanks.
So. Too bad.
Well, let's see how it goes.
So you can see that Japan is going for the Chinese puppet focus, which has a 60% chance of succeeding. Like, it's a flat 60% chance, there are no modifiers, and a 40% chance they don't do it. So, RNG, please help us. Alright, let's do this. And right now we should go to an easy victory.
Oh,
we have enough units.
Just cut his way out. Well, yeah, that's the thing with tanks. You can just kind of push your way through anything.
Yeah, tanks are fast.
Interesting division design. It's, well, at least for me, it shows that he has between 4 and 6 light tank regiments and 3 to 5.
We have him cut off again.
Yeah, I have him cut off again.
Whatever, whatever you do, I mean, that's already annoying to him.
Yeah, but he has a lot of tanks, though.
Keep them bogged down.
Yeah, I know. I'm probably gonna take his tanks. Come on.
Awesome.
Do it. We're gonna win. Beat his tanks. Tanks and mountaineers.
There's one tank and mountain.
Division. I've destroyed two divisions. And number three is about to happen.
So this is already going quite in our favor. Getting some of his units.
It is.
Exactly. The supplies are being drained by that. This tank will
not
fall.
My ring, the way I should. Oh my god! GG! RNG went our way.
So we okay. now have right. China as our puppet.
Next game.
Okay, next game.
This is really going really well.
It's too well, in fact. Alright, destroy his tanks and his mountaineers.
So we are going for reassert Eastern claims.
13 war tension, though.
We're going to go for trying to go Danzig or war really, really fast.
Oh, did the puppet get generated?
Nope.
No, it's not me.
He sent extra volunteers? Oh yeah, Anschluss for me.
Germany. Yeah, that's Anschluss. Okay, that's fine. It had to happen, so...
Yep.
Inevitable stuff, let's just leave it.
Yeah, sorry about that, I have those things.
Oh my goodness.
Huge normal.
I'm just about to get another... Yeah, I'm
gonna... Oh, you wiped one already?
I destroyed
one. Oh yeah.
He's motorized too.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. You got some.
Oh, I destroyed all of his units!
GG. Things are going really well for us.
Well, okay, but do not push for Madrid, though.
Yeah, just drag it out.
I am just going to kill units. I'm going to sit here and kill units for army XP. It's basically it. Oh boy, but yeah, Russia is gone.
Yeah, those were Russian volunteers. Yeah, just make sure that you actually don't put any power into it, because the National of Spain might actually do it by themselves.
Yeah, that's true. I can't destroy too many divisions then. But I need army XP. I only got 11.
Make them bog down. It's just a couple of days more.
Stuff not near victory.
If I were him, I would send
poor Bridger.
Divisions. Okay, you are about to win this civil war, though.
The war is going way too well. Just pretty much stop.
Yeah, just stop. Just
okay.
Do not
fight. Yeah, I understand. I understand.
Chill, guys. Let me kill three more divisions and then.
But you're doing really well. Those five divisions are really valuable for the USSR.
I know, but chill. I need a bit more army XP. I need to fix my artillery situation with my divisions. You do know that Japan's divisions start out the shittiest of all, right?
They're really bad. It's really important. You can get XP later on as well. Really important. 25 is really hard limit.
I have no wars until Soviet Union, so I need to get the XP.
But if things go wrong, then there won't be a war with the Soviet Union for a while.
Don't worry, man. It's happening.
Yeah, just
it's
make
happening.
Sure you don't take Madrid and Barcelona, but otherwise you.
Like I said,
fine.
I'm not going for. Yeah.
But the AI might, and that's a problem.
XP.
Yeah, I'm just killing stuff and getting it.
I think we'll be fine. Plan.
Just fighting. Oh, this is great XP.
The Soviet Union sent new divisions to Republican Spain.
They're
so don't kill those.
Up.
Really, don't kill those.
So tension is 18 now.
Yeah, that's a problem. Don't do anything.
Well, now the cat is out of the bag. So, if United Kingdom wants to guarantee Poland, they will.
No, they can't. 25%.
They still can.
Oh,
yeah, all
right, 25, of course. I'm.
They involved. Still can. Don't worry.
Don't do anything.
We can go the war economy now. I'm not sure if it's worth it though.
Yeah, I figured that would happen as well, so I was kind of against it, but I mean, our Japan player is a little bit, like, underwhelmed right now. He doesn't have that much to do, and I understand his eagerness for doing that, but it might, like, make our plan fall if it goes too aggressive.
Did he send new divisions?
Yeah, he did send five extra. They will be on their way in, like, 20 days from when they sent them.
Oh, yeah, he did.
I don't see any, but I'm gonna wait for him to show up. I wanna kill his divisions.
He said, yeah, no, don't, because then he will send new.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Raise will tension?
Yeah.
Except you can't let them win either, because once
you can let that, well that, they will, they right, will be I'll far away from winning. Just bog down.
I will just chill. I'll just chill here then.
That's all right. Just have you guys saved up the political power for war economy?
No, I'm not going for that.
I have. I'm switched. I need to.
Yeah, I understand you need to. I'd rather have a little bit of extra power for my armies when I'm invading Poland.
Alright, Germany, just send 3 factories your way.
Yeah, I mean, it doesn't really necessarily need to defend the cities that much. You just need to make sure that the AI doesn't take too many cities.
I still do not see Soviet tanks anywhere.
They should be there.
They haven't gotten there yet, I don't think.
Have not arrived.
He sent them on the... Oh, maybe that was old? Oh, actually, he did. Yeah, he did send extra. 10th of June. So he should be there now.
Alright, let me just encircle a couple of divisions and then I'll stop.
No, really, stop, because the AI will win the war. The AI will win the
AI
war.
AI doesn't have enough to win right now. He can... And as long as he stops, he'll need to stop the Russians from winning, too.
The Russians cannot win. They're too far away from now. He can just defend the cities. We're 85 days away from winning this game, pretty much, so please just hold a little bit constrained.
Chill, relax. Win this.
I think we will. Yeah, especially with the puppet of China, we are going to have a really big advantage already going into this game.
Exactly. It's massive.
So these Austrian divisions should form up to be the true and new divisions. These guys make a beautiful big line over here.
Push through Mongolia, as we discussed. If so, you would probably need to get...
And the line, like, over here.
I can't fix the infrastructure in China, though, so... Let's
go over here, and then focus on...
No, you would have to go from Manchuria.
Come on.
Like
here.
From Mongolia, basically. That two provinces that you have from Mongolia.
Yeah, it's maybe a little bit too ambitious, saying 85 days from victory, but things are going well.
Decent infrastructure in those two provinces, or perhaps even an additional port level or two in the Yatung one, then you should be good. Just check which port is going through and...
Have you found the Soviet divisions yet?
What? Sorry?
Have you found the Soviet divisions?
No, I wasn't paying attention because I wasn't pushing.
Very well.
Yeah.
So London in 86 days. Well, yeah, maybe. It would be glorious if we could manage the tactic. Of course, things are never going the way I want them to go when they're multiplayer, but we're doing well so far.
No, we can see them. We should be able to see them all. But I do not see a single one.
Maybe they're just still in a port and he has to assign them to a front line where you can see them.
Maybe he's not paying attention again.
Maybe.
They have 2 players in Soviet Union.
No, they don't. They don't.
They don't?
Nah, some guy didn't show up. So the guy from PRC. So they have one guy in PRC and one guy in Soviet Union.
Oh.
They are bone.
I don't think they're bone, but...
If our plan succeeds, they are.
Yeah, but
The Soviet Union guy will have some issues.
We have 100 guys right now. This is going to be our army.
Allow them to
some guys who are pretty good. Some guys who need a lot of extra equipment. So that's what we're focusing on right now, getting more equipment and stuff like that. But we should have enough for this. And that's what I want to go at. Danzig or war.
No, they have a co-op player for Soviet Union.
Really?
And Eastwood. Yeah, Bridger and Eastwood.
Okay, I thought somebody didn't show up. Never mind then.
It's the guy PRC is alone.
Yeah, but he was supposed to be alone.
Someone didn't show up, but he replaced him with someone else.
Okay.
That's right, yeah, the guy playing PRC now is the replacement.
Alright, Danzig War!
Victory. Already?
Yeah!
Oh, right.
Yeah. We have to... We can't let the world tension go up another...
Gdansk? You want me to say Gdansk? I mean, that's the Polish name.
Yeah, we're fine.
Before that's done.
But I'm pretty bad with pronouncing names. You're gonna love the way I pronounce Warsaw. I have no idea how to really pronounce it in either England or English or Polish.
No, Poland.
I don't think Poland is gonna take it.
I don't think he needs unless you mean
Germany is gonna take Poland.
Did they reinforce Poland? Did the Soviet Union help Poland or something?
No, they didn't. Why?
Should be fine then. Should be easy roll.
Yeah, we should be able to steamroll Poland when we declare war. Just need to have no world tension spike coming to us. 5%.
Okay, I will take care of southern Poland.
So the Soviet Union just started the Great Purge. Beautiful. I couldn't have wanted it any better.
Oh my god, that's just suicidal.
Timing is... I mean, he doesn't expect it. He's not expecting it.
So, that's really good.
Yeah. Yeah, it will hit him pretty hard. I think it should be GG. We'll see. Maybe he is prepared for it. We'll see.
Just noting down what the USA and the UK are doing.
I love for them to have made that decision and then check our focus and be like, oh no, Danzig or war.
And the USA is going for Monroe Doctrine.
Not just Danzig or war, they will check my focus and they see that, oh my god, we're coming after them.
Caribbean.
And then it hits him and he'll be like, oh damn.
So yeah, the Nationalist Spain is doing really well though in Spain.
Yeah, I'm just holding the lines here.
We need another 50 days.
Yeah, they can't take Barcelona.
They will be fine.
Yeah, they'll be fine. They are not attacking very effectively anyway.
It should be really a low percentage that they actually give Danzig.
Well, it's fine because, AI is doing retarded things as usual.
And we have AI, historical AI, so they should say no indeed. But there is a chance, literally. RNG could screw us on this front.
Wonder how much it will go up when People's Republic of China does another declaration, because they have
about one, maybe two. It goes really low because they're small.
Yeah, I think theirs is small because it's the state.
So the last time they declared war was 0.8.
Oh, less than 1%. Yeah, I think we're fine.
I think we should be fine. I mean, we're 40 days away.
Yeah, okay, I guess I
planes are fine as well.
Training for my troops.
Yeah.
You shouldn't train.
I'm doing training, I think. Though. Yeah, I'm training because there is no choice.
Another war.
Less XP this way.
So yeah, that was 1%. That's not enough for them. Yeah, exactly. That's the reason why it goes up so little, and that's really good. We don't want the spike. We want to keep world tension low. 23%.
Yep.
Because
I was
Soviet
how
Union
much
joined.
Put it up by Soviets for the volunteers.
Nah, they just literally joined.
Yep.
Write some more tech.
What would you like next?
Let's see.
Wait
30 days and they get improved machine tools.
Yeah.
Hey, PRC is attacking C base on Ma. Should be fine.
We are fine as it is. 30 days.
Yeah, we have at best 12 divisions.
I think we'll be done. We might be done with Poland before they're done with Z base and Ma.
Yeah, I think so. We will gobble up Poland in like a month maximum.
How is your equipment production? You good on it?
Not that great, but it's like the way it should be at this point. Oh, we should modify our divisions. I will do that. So we're going to go for the best division that there is for us.
I will switch the
add some artillery. Yeah, but we should do that. Oh, we have too much guys?
Do you have support artillery in your divisions?
Yeah, we do.
I think I should have that's two of us.
I like them a lot. They're my favorite support division.
Yeah, of course, but I'm just pretty low on the whole artillery thingy, but should be enough.
Yeah, just make sure that you can actually put artillery in there. If they have like zero artillery, it doesn't make any use. It's a waste of army experience then.
Just let me do the math.
20 days.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, I will be just a few weeks behind when the war starts. I should be able to catch
Yeah, that should be no problem. So I won't be calling either Italy or Japan into the war. That should be fine.
Okay. Oh, right.
Yeah, you guys will not be in the war, just so that you know. It will spike world tension a little bit more. Yeah, that's kind of how I feel. Like, let nothing go wrong. It's only 13 days. Please, 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 please. Once we're at war with Poland, they will not be able to guarantee. So that we should be fine.
Right.
There is this really small chance that they actually might screw things up. But I don't think that will happen. But it could. And if it is, then things are going wrong. Big time.
I'll spare a guy for Roshan. Can you just check on Spain and let me know if my unit get in trouble because I'm not paying attention to them right now, just in case.
Okay. So 8 days. There's always a chance that things will go wrong really soon now. So be aware that the UK might declare war on us. France will not be in it, but just be aware that they might declare war on us.
Sure. I have to keep some missions in reserve.
If that happens, I will call you guys in probably. Well, we don't have to go Molotov-Ribbentrop Pact. The only thing that really matters right then is that the UK could do some naval invasions or something like that.
I cannot... my submarines can't pass through Bosphorus. I think we fucked this one up.
Yeah, that's fine, that's fine. Just go reinforce the Polish border. Just go do that.
Yeah, then go for the Polish border.
Yeah, it's not the end of the world. We can still do this.
Yeah, we're fine. Alright, one day.
That would be fancy. Yeah.
The UK player is bad.
Yeah, don't be like that.
No, but really, because they could have guaranteed Poland in that window. There was a one-day window they could guarantee them.
Well, they would have to pause them.
Yeah, okay, maybe that's it.
Have a political power for it, so...
Ah, that's true. But they could see it coming. But yeah, I was really afraid they would. I can invite Xibai San Ma. Do you guys want them in the faction?
No, because...
No, they're at war.
Start the war with USSR.
Alright.
Hey, you know what? They give us a discount. I don't have to take the national focus. We'll just go to war.
Yeah, that's actually true.
You save us the trouble, you know? We should do it.
Yeah, I can invite them to the faction, so this should be fine.
But don't join the war.
We're still fighting Poland right now, though.
No. Just
no, not yet, not yet.
Don't join the war. Yeah, but don't join the war.
Well, I will not even invite them yet. I mean, why should we then?
Yeah, we don't get anything from that.
Yeah, but just wait a little bit. Okay, so the planes is good. Well, okay, and maybe I was a little bit mean saying he's a bad player, but I was really afraid he would guarantee them in that one-day window that they had. And that would make things really bad for us. But now things are going well. Alright, I will start improving relations with some nations. They joined the allies. What? Please win quickly. I didn't know that was actually possible.
It is possible.
Hmm.
Poland can always insta-jump.
No, not really, because I thought they couldn't because world tension was not high enough. I thought they needed 50 world tension.
I think it's 40.
Ah, maybe that's it. Things spiked a little bit too much.
It's fine, we'll deal with it.
We're fine, we just go to war with the USSR quickly. Alright, I need some defense of my sea border if possible.
Yeah,
can you send some stuff over there, Italy? Italy on coastal defense?
Yeah, send some. I'd rather not, but...
Well, we kinda have to.
I have to defend my own seabird as well.
Yeah, but if you can send them to me, then I can declare war on USSR soon.
Right, can we slow this down now?
Yeah, sure, with speed too.
Innocentius, I can deal with it. I'll grab a few of our guys. Not too many, just our worst troops.
Yeah, that sounds fine.
Oh, too many. Hold on. There, that should be enough. I will,
Italy, where do you have your fleet station at the moment?
Nowhere, really.
You should position them soon. If I'm not inviting you yet
I'm
into
the
war.
I'm not sure if I want to use them right now, or I want to save them. I think I want to save them.
Yeah, that's fine, but just make sure that they're out of range from naval bombers and stuff like that.
Yeah, well, it would be hard, but I think I will just put them in Eritrea. Because, well, in Mediterranean, they won't be out of range anyway.
Yeah, exactly. Just be aware that the things like that happen. You got every division you wanted from the German army out?
I might need more for the west. In a little bit, but it's okay for now.
We have still a naval dominance of the Baltic Sea, so pretty much it's just left of Denmark.
Okay.
Yeah, that's sad because now I won't have Finland join into the war. I don't think we can get them. Well, just maybe if we can get them to sign the Sofia Anti-Comintern Pact. Which I'm doing right now. But at least we have Yugoslavia and Bulgaria. Oh right, when the pass is neutral you can't pass submarines through it. I thought you could. Maybe they changed that.
Yeah. Okay, I will take south, by the way. So don't send me the motorized divisions again.
Alright. Then I will use the motorized divisions and stuff like that for myself to rush towards Moscow. Japan, what focus are you taking at the moment?
I'll be taking Northern Expansion.
Alright, good. Go in. Yeah, because I don't have the option to invite a faction anymore.
Do you see the Moser region?
Let me check.
This the swamps region. So
all right, yeah, yeah. Okay, so if you go to the air map, you're gonna take Ukraine. If you look at the air map, you will take Ukraine, and I will take Belarus.
Yep.
All right.
Hey, sea base ammo is going down. So if you wanna do this, we need to take it now.
Yeah, yeah. You need to take it now.
No, it's okay, fine. I have the...
There are not much Soviet divisions on the border yet.
After anti-Soviet pact, we might want to do Reichsautobahn and Westwall just to make sure we don't get killed from behind by France while we're fighting.
Right. I was going befriend Czechoslovakia and then second Vienna wards into befriend Turkey. But I'm up to suggestions. Maybe we want to train in a couple of extra weak divisions just to make sure for naval stuff.
I'll take care of that.
Alright. Italy, why you have troops going for Czechoslovakia? We don't need that.
Oh, I haven't. They were just there to gather the...
Ah, okay.
I'll use the other bad template. I'll change that.
Yeah, we have 66 army experience. You can modify a lot of it.
I need more army experience. But I'm not fighting.
You'll be fighting soon.
Yep, we will be. And I'll get to put my artillery back in there.
So I really hope that the Japanese border will keep the Soviet Union busy for a while, because that will mean we'll be able to push in really hard. With the UK in the war right now, we just have to hold Moscow for a month, while we don't lose Berlin or Rome. Italy, make sure that you keep defending your home territory, because right now you have nothing in your home territory and you will be at war with the UK soon.
I'm recruiting some stuff, so...
Okay. If you're lucky, then I will be able to keep you out of the war, but I've seen some shady shit happening with merging of wars. You shouldn't be pulled into the war with the UK if I can handle it, though. Because right now I'm only in that war and I'm not gonna call you in.
I'm completely ignoring Africa, by the way, but...
Okay, yeah, you should.
Ooh, I need to train some police divisions.
Ah, right, we have resistance now from Poland.
Make sure you have manpower and shit.
People's Republic of China is growing as well.
Yep, that's fine, it's fine. It means that Soviet Union is weak, because he's feeding him.
Yeah, his border is really weak at the moment.
I do not see myself having trouble picking him, so...
Awesome. I like to hear that. Sure. Now, our equipment situation is not terribly bad. Could be worse. Yeah, the USSR is pretty screwed. Yeah. That's pretty much all I can say about
the war
it.
The war is coming because we've set it up already.
Yeah, they know that you are they're going to declare war. Their border with me is really weak.
Okay, guys, 45 days before war. It's Soviet Union.
Oh, really? You took it later?
Is it later?
Yeah, I have 35 days to my next thing.
Yeah, I might have missed a few days then.
No problem. So their purge will be done relatively soon as well, which is glorious! UK is going for general rearmament. And USA is doing war propaganda.
Civil war, because that messes things up.
No, not that soon. 39, I think, civil war.
Even if that happens, it won't mess us up. It will mess them up more than us. We can just declare war if we need to.
You can also invite the party that, civil war party into access.
Yeah, right. But no, I can't invite anybody right now. Well, what do you mean? If Russia gets
a civil war.
Ah,
yeah,
right.
If they get civil war, we'll just invite whoever they're fighting into the war, and then we join the war.
Let's see. Did we improve relations with all these guys?
Can't believe it, but it looks like Republican Spain is pushing.
Doesn't matter.
That's really doesn't matter.
The AI has fucked up.
Oh, you can
help them.
You can take Spain now. It's the world tension is too high to matter. You can just use your units.
If you want to ask some questions, you can. I will be a little bit distracted, but you can.
Nation.
And yeah, I do think that this game will end before 1937.
They've clearly fucked up.
We went for this really, really aggressive strat.
Is your fleet still alive? With UK in the game?
Yeah, my fleet is fine. I didn't even engage them.
Oh, I could probably send my fleet to Japan.
I don't think Japan needs it.
I don't have a problem.
Just try to block.
I don't think you could make it to Japan.
If you can, try to block the northern edge of the Soviet Union. So that would be the Barents Sea.
I do. Yes, and then nothing's coming through. Because that's all I can do with my navy anyway. I don't want to go.
I'm sending my navy there because I can't fight.
No, you don't.
United Kingdom here.
All right.
Okay.
Yeah, that's pretty good. Just block the USSR completely off. I have the Baltic Sea under control. If you do a
If you do that, you have to be careful of France naval invading Italy. Because
France is not an ally.
Oh.
Yeah.
All right, so he can't do shit, right?
Nope. I keep a tabs on France. France is not in the allies. They will take a while before they go with Britain.
All right, 35 days. Go. They are reinforcing the eastern border.
Awesome.
Thanks. I see so big.
They really need to reinforce all the borders, though.
Yeah, they do.
We're gonna push through the borders so easily. I have them outnumbered by like what, 4-1? Easily, 5-1 almost. Yeah. And that's just my forces.
Same here, yeah. Me too. But just don't. She's moving out some of the divisions from here. Interesting. You have 30 divisions in the marches. Do not. Just use like three divisions in those three provinces in the marches.
Nah, it will be fine.
It's a waste. Just use like 6 divisions in those 3 provinces combined. The rest put north. It's completely not worth it.
Okay.
The only problem with our timing is that we're attacking Russia in winter.
No problem. We will be in Moscow in summer.
I remember someone just saying that.
I heard it once before as well.
Yeah. What can possibly go wrong?
Exactly.
They know what's happening, and yeah, they have some time to prep for it.
Yeah, they failed miserably, I think, with the prep.
Is perched, so yeah, he's gonna be in so much trouble.
He's gonna be in a lot.
Okay, they're trying to get Finland into their side.
Really? How?
Yeah. Improving relations and supporting growth of political parties.
That's not gonna do it though.
But it will stop you from.
Should we do that?
No, I don't think
so. Spare political power.
Yeah, smaller air units are better. Be nice. That's kind of a bug in the game. They use every like separate air thing.
I guess if you want to, we can.
To search for other enemies, and therefore smaller units are being able to find more enemies.
Yeah, okay. I don't like it.
And that will really help.
So let's stick to this.
17 days to war. No naval invasion spotted yet.
Yeah, I will have my third doctrine ready by then.
Nice.
And my artillery ready, and well, everything really. I'm pretty much set.
Yeah, I'm really set up, and we're gonna rumble.
Yeah. And
okay, they have 7 divisions on our front right now. I can literally walk to Moscow in a month.
For some reason,
they are think up on the next river or something, because this part is undefendable.
Oh yeah, they probably are, but that's fine. We will be able to push through that easily.
All right, so if you guys are training your units, it's about time to stop the training because.
Yeah, good point. I'm not training.
Yeah, because we're gonna go to war soon, and you don't want to have no org. Wow, he has a lot of tanks in Bangkoko.
Everything he has there, he doesn't have in on our front.
Yes, tank 10 tank divisions here. See him.
Beautiful.
Right here.
Yeah, they shouldn't be able to fend us off.
I agree.
I don't know why, but some of my divisions refuse to gain a max spawning bonus, which is weird. They are stuck at 44%.
Only lose 5k men. Ah, that's gonna be great. I'm not that good at the game, so I can't do those kinds of things. Alright, anti-Comintern Pact. So what do you want to focus on? The West Wall and stuff like that?
Yeah, we should get West Wall.
Sure, let's do that. Reichsautobahn first, then. I can't get Finland to join the war, unfortunately, because we are already in a war. That's what is bugging them down, otherwise they will be able to join the faction. Good thing is, though, that the UK only has like 30 divisions.
Strangely, I don't see a single... Well, I see one...
They are fortifying behind a river, I guess.
Yeah, probably.
So we have to micro that a lot.
That makes sense. If they try to defend from the border, they would be overrun. So that's...
Birch will be done soon as well. Like 63 days or 67 days. Six days to war.
By the way, are
16 days.
Are we pausing for the start of the war or not? How is it?
You're 20 days
behind them.
Just speed two. Speed two is fine.
Yeah, this is fine. I have somehow a battle plan with no units
aside. Prepared for an allies jump in though. Probably something will go on.
Yeah, probably. We have control of the Baltic Strait though, so we only have to fortify on the left side. And right now France is not joining yet. So be careful with the French joining in as well for you, Endel. I don't think you're gonna go in the war with them, but we might. And then they might spill over to your land, but I'm not sure. If you need extra units for Ocean, you can always take them.
Wow, they played a smart move. They pulled out of Vladivostok.
So I could use a
They've abandoned Vladivostok over in Soviet Union.
Yeah,
they pulled out.
Smart move though.
Yeah, because I would just cut them off.
Exactly. And make sure the Italian divisions are pointing towards Moscow as well, because Moscow is our target.
Interesting. Not, I cannot put my
Well, you can kill it. You literally can, but it's really difficult. You need to be searching pretty much for them. It's not a bug. They don't surrender their fleet to you. So technically, there's a Polish government in exile at the moment.
You can't use allied airfield sometimes.
So right now, you can see them swimming around. And if I was using these fleets to hunt for them,
exactly.
I would be able to find them, and I would be able to kill them, but I just need to find them.
I don't understand. If anybody finds out, do let me know.
I'm just going to halt this one division in Warsaw because the police can't train yet because of infantry equipment.
Yeah,
so
that's fine.
They're sabotaging all of our nice new factories.
Ah, of course. 8 days left. Yeah, Poland joined the Allies right before they died. I thought it wasn't possible, but unfortunately they did. My mistake. I thought it was 50%, but it apparently was lower. Kind of a bad mistake. It made sure that we are at war with the Allies right now, which I was trying to avoid. But the USA can't join the Allies until war tension hits 100%, and then they need to wait another year.
Caught up on infantry equipment.
Yeah, that's good.
I don't see any allied navy in the Baltic Sea. Is someone going to keep that?
I have a navy in the allied sea. Baltic Sea.
Navy. Oh, I can't see it. Damn it. Oh.
Yeah, we have complete navy control of the Baltic Sea. All of our ships, literally.
Yeah, right. You got subs there doing convoy raids as well, right?
Yep.
Yep.
All right. And we're sweet.
So the USA probably won't be doing the war. Because they need a year from the moment world tension hits 100%.
I should probably send some of my subs into the Atlantic, but no, fuck.
Yeah, maybe just to keep the UK away or something like that. So waiting for the war declaration of Japan.
Since we are planning to... I can't reach anything here, so anyway.
You can also use my naval bases, maybe that helps.
Nope.
Alright. What are we training? Because that's what Ferocean is handling right now. That looks fine. Let's take a look at the garrison unit. Small garrison unit with some artillery. Yeah, looks absolutely fine. Almost caught up with infantry equipment, just takes 45 days to follow up. But that's gonna go down a lot because we're gonna go to war. And we're also going to produce some heavy artillery soon, self-propelled. It's a pretty good unit, but really expensive to build up.
Okay, war is started. Ready?
Yep. Invite us!
Alright, let's do this.
Where is my invite? Give me an invite. Declare war. Invite, please. Invite me, please.
You guys can request. It's easier than me going to invite.
Okay. Request.
But I got it. I got it, Skip. Alright, you guys got it. Join. Let's do this.
Here we go.
Accept.
January 37, D-Day.
Alright,
wow,
we're going
in. Wow, they completely pulled out.
They pulled out
of the Soviet border.
I think they're behind a river. That's what we were discussing about.
They probably went river.
Go from Mongolia, as I said. Go from Mongolia.
Oh, don't worry, guys. I am pushing. I know how to play this game.
Yeah, I just... You know, pushing north is kind of pointless. That's what I'm trying to say, because...
They have so many Soviet... all their ships are here.
Good.
My fleet is here too. Going to destroy all their fleet. 21 subs, 8 destroyers.
If we manage to break through over here on the river,
it's gonna be good.
That's gonna be beautiful.
I'm sending my fleet too, because why not?
Well, alright, may as well. Holy shit, he sunk all my subs. His destroyer sunk all my subs. How is that even possible? 8 destroyers sank 21 subs.
Yeah,
wow.
That's. Yep.
Really? Well, anyway, my main.
So they were trying to reinforce from here. I cut that off easily. You guys should go here and then attack as well to get a little bit extra width. And we are pushing through over here.
I'll just leave AI to do their shit.
Friends, George allies.
That's why I wanted Westwall.
Yep. Alright, we have all our allies in as well. Just need to push to Moscow.
Yep.
Japan is still... France is still AI, so they're stupid. You can pull troops away from the front if you need.
Yeah, I have pulled
You can pull like 10 more if you want. I've broken through the river.
Okay, we need to change our surface fleet to search and destroy against the Soviet fleet, or they'll just kill all of our subs. Ooh, nice. About to sink a bunch of British subs.
Nice.
Oh man, this is... Soviets are really fucking up here, because I see a doom stack of 10 facing 10% attrition in one spot. They have no front line. I don't know who's running this army, man, but...
I'm pushing... They fell back behind the river, but I'm... pushing through easily. It's going really well.
If we start being bogged down, I will do the. I will just use Odessa for.
I think we'll be fine. I'm past the river already at one point and pushing through on several other points. We're finally encountering some UK Navy, but nothing big, just some subs. The moment we lose naval superiority there, then we can be in shit creek. So let's do some microing, just going to go around a little bit, see if we can move up our front. All sides were winning. Yeah, and the USSR is definitely low on infantry equipment because of feeding, and that's why they have a lot less units available to them.
And I should be behind the river in no time.
All right. Yeah, I'm crossing multiple points on the river, in the north and in the south as well. That's Kiev. Now the purge is not even over yet.
Yeah, he hasn't started the purge. I mean, the purge hasn't started.
The effects of the purge are not even in yet, so this is literally us fighting him at full strength.
Yeah, but it's fine. It'll get even worse for him.
Yeah, exactly.
It'll get any better, so... Poor guy. Sucks to be Bridger right now.
Yeah, it really does.
Then again, he did pick Soviet Union.
Yeah. And he failed to see some signs.
Yeah.
And we were telling him.
I gave him all the pointers. I even told him that Japan is not going to sit around and watch you boost People's Republic, so...
The losses are low on both sides at the moment, though.
Oh, I know what's going on.
I wonder if they just have a huge group right around Moscow or something with a bunch of land forts.
Probably.
So the People's Republic didn't join the war. I was wondering why my units were...
Oh, really?
Yeah, they didn't join
right.
the war.
Weird.
So the unit didn't invite them to war. I think they were just trying to protect them because... But it's too late anyway, because I'm attacking.
Should
I'm
be.
Justifying directly now, so...
It almost makes no sense. It's like, what's their
plan? No, because,
plan?
No, because it makes perfect sense, because if you look at the border, he has no troops. And I have like 50 divisions waiting on the Chinese border. He's like, oh no, no war! Because if he goes to war, he's gonna get crushed.
And the justification should be quick now, right?
Yes, it's 25 days, so I just went in and justified anyway, because why not? Why not?
Yeah, exactly.
We're gonna move our armor down into the plains.
Sure. Yeah, I'm just doing a little bit in the north right now. Because there's no troops there at all, so I've just, like, taking whatever I can.
Okay, I bet Bridger's in the Allied channel saying, please help me, help me, I'll sell you my left.
Alright, our fleet is getting beaten up really badly by some Soviet ships. Oh, we're actually sinking more of them than they are of us. So if things are okay. Okay, now we're winning.
They just lost like 20 subs.
They lost like a lot of their stuff. We're fine, never mind.
Ooh. Port strikes. I have to move make sure that the ship is a different home base.
Use the one in the East Prussia.
They will use, yes. There we go.
Yeah, we beat, like, we killed like 40 subs and a couple of destroyers. Yeah, we're fine. Yeah, if he's going for the defense of Moscow, taking Moscow itself will be a little bit more difficult, but I don't expect much problems with it. We have some encirclement going on here. That's always nice. Now let's see what they have around Moscow. We're going closer and closer. And they are just in a full rout pretty much right now. Look at Italy pushing down in the south. It's beautiful. Yeah, the losses are ramping. Yeah, 6 divisions, they're gonna be destroyed. Oh, and we have the rules that they can't just delete them right now. You need to go there. So let's see if they have anything in Leningrad.
Crush the pocket.
Yeah, the pocket is being crushed. They have nothing in Leningrad, so we'll be easily taking that out.
Walking right into it, good.
Yep.
And their ships won't have a home port to repair at anymore either.
Exactly.
Spit them out into the channel. Or into the Baltic Sea, I mean.
So how I did it is pretty much push out as many divisions as I can. Just focus everything on putting out the divisions as fast as you can. Which means they're poorly trained, poorly equipped, but we're just using manpower.
Prevented the forces from being destroyed though, like... How many divisions have we crushed? Like 10?
We haven't crushed many. They only lost like 29k.
Yeah, they will lose another 9 divisions in a sec. But...
I have 4 over here in mine place. That was Leningrad.
Good job.
Have they hired Cunningham yet?
I'm gonna keep one guy.
Sorry,
there.
What?
Since maybe we can finish them before the purge, though, because it's still minus 25 from Trotsky plot.
So yeah, now we're getting problems with our stuff.
Yeah, they're 80%.
Our fleet is getting destroyed, by the way, so protect the flanks.
Yep. Yeah, I have to move them. I have to set them to do not engage.
Yeah.
Yeah. There we go. Tell them to go hide in the port.
Italy, if you could rush towards Stalingrad, maybe we can finish it.
I'm kind of doing that, but it's
okay.
And I do not have motorized division, so
no problem.
If you could redeploy a single motorized division here to the further point.
Alright, so I'm moving my navy over. Allied attack. I expect allies will jump in at any point, so.
Yeah, I expect allies being there as well soon.
Not sure if they can already. It's only 85. I think they need 100 to join the war.
Oh, maybe that's true. Yeah, right now I'm just the only one at war.
This is hilarious. People's Republic of China wants a non-attack. Wars.
Who? People's Republic of China?
People's Republic of China sent me a non-attack. Alright, I considered it. I sat on my table, I smoked a cigar, I thought about it, and I said
the reason why no war till 38 is bad is because it limits the Axis, like, a lot. It's really difficult to balance this kind of game. Because you don't want the Axis to have the cakewalk, like we're pretty much doing right now. But if you limit us to not going to war until 38, then yeah, we're really limited.
They only move on strategic redeployment. I was pissed off when they were strategic redeploying, but this is worse because they just can't keep up.
All right, go over there. How long till the purchase done? Yeah, it's just a couple more days.
Well, our navy did its job, and now it just gets to sit in port for the rest of the game.
Wait, why is it lagging?
Did we?
Oh, ho, ho, ho.
We capitulated them.
We just have to hold it.
One month timer.
Remember.
Oh my god.
Alright. Well, Moscow fell off Sevastopol. Right, so. Who takes what? That's the question.
Doesn't matter, we just hold it.
Yeah.
Yeah, we win, so I don't know. You wanna just puppet them?
just puppet everything. The whole lot.
Take some stuff and I will puppet them.
Just puppet them, let them play. Okay. But they have to work for us now. I'll go into the channel and tell them, you work for us now. Please pop at them.
Just in case it screws up our victory.
We need to control Moscow.
Okay, you know we what? Let's everyone pass and
the AI will take stuff.
Still alive on this.
Take Moscow and then pop at the rest because Moscow's the victory.
I think maybe I should take Moscow because I have most divisions, I guess.
Yeah. Yeah. You take Moscow and then just pop at the rest and then we'll just tell them, hey, GG, well played.
Okay,
yeah.
So we will be passed.
All right,
hey there!
For breaking the rules.
What rule?
No. Not breaking the rules. Breaking the rule set.
Ah, that's right.
You guys figured out how to get around it pretty damn well.
Yeah.
I know, man. We kept telling you about it, and you said no. Let's give the Soviet Union some more.
Okay, what? So the next game, no German human player until 1943.
Something like that.
Play a laissez-faire Soviet Union. The entire thing, I was like, we'll just plan for the war starting in 39. Nope.
37, 36 it was, I believe.
Yeah,
I heard you talking about land-leasing PRC, and I'm thinking, if you land-lease them, that's your production going to them. It doesn't actually help you.
Yeah.
But it would help them, and they are us.
Republican Spain lasted, though.
Yeah, they did.
Of course. Yeah. It lasted longer than the Soviet Union. Wait a minute. The world reset to like, why does Republican Spain look identical?
Because
it's showing
it
only cores.
Oh, okay.
All right. I will pause.
Oh, yeah.
So Italy, just puppet them?
No, I don't like not being allowed
to do things. I don't like restrictions. I like consequences. So we got to come up with a rule set that works within that.
Dude, just take out all the rules. Let everybody do whatever they want. It doesn't involve exploits.
That's not competitive at all.
Well, it would limit this.
Everybody can do everything.
It is true that having Japan take nationalist China as a puppet might be a little too good of a possibility.
60% chance.
Yeah. I still don't think that matters.
No, it didn't play a huge
matter at all. Because all the divisions, I got from China just sat on the PRC border and nothing happened, so.
Yeah, well, right, we couldn't call in PRC. Communist China because of that border, though.
Yeah. Really? Oh, yeah, right.
Well, yeah, it was definitely well played. It was absolutely well played.
Even if you had, you had no chance on stopping us in the Western Front, I don't think.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the West was easy.
I know you did. We only had 37, I think. No, we had 40 when the tanks showed up.
Yeah, I had like 90 by myself.
There were proper divisions, like 7 infantry to... to artillery. And
I forgot
shit,
how
like,
much in
well
debt
trained.
Of equipment the Soviets started. It's like 20,000.
No, I thought it was 000. More. I thought it was almost 100.
Negative.
No, it's not 64.
No?
I think it's like 25,000.
I think it was 64.
I know the US starts at a deficit of 27,000. So, I mean, 64 for the Soviet Union sounds kind of reasonable with all the stuff they went through.
Yeah, kind of. Why am I demanding stuff and not doing anything?
No, we don't want any more people in the game as miners. Absolutely not. We want fewer people for faster gameplay. That's how you work. You've already got 10. 10's a good number. So, is there a way to prevent early aggression?
Well, I think that Danzico War should be limited to January 38.
That's an interesting one.
Or 39. Yeah.
No, not 39, 38.
There's you can't even use Danziger War by 38. The tension's too high. I mean, why not just manually justify by that
right.
point?
Right.
We will then, probably. But yes. It will prevent this from happening.
Deleting all the weaker divisions early didn't do anything. It just redistributed them into new divisions.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. That's why I always do it, because they're useless, and they don't have veterancy, so you're not even losing that.
Why don't we give you guys a France player and that should even things up?
That should help a lot though.
I still don't think that. But in this situation with France player, you wouldn't have survived either. Because, well, we are not defending.
Defending against the Maginot is not hard, you're right. Not in 37. France couldn't come back and.
Yeah, that's true as well. But actually, it will take a lot of units from our border.
That's not exactly true. I've seen France rush Germany in 36 and win. So
yeah, but in multiplayer.
Yeah, in multiplayer. Because
I'm sure there were things that I didn't do very well. I haven't played a lot of Soviet Union, to be honest.
You got crushed in Spain.
I did. I fucked up so bad in Spain. Oh my god! I got super cocky. I'm like, we just cut off the entire Southern Nationalists. Let me just go up here and try to do it again.
And you lost. Yeah.
I got too cocky against the AI. I didn't see the Japanese there. I'm like, where are all the Germans? And I didn't see the Japanese.
Yeah, I didn't send anything on purpose.
No, I was paying attention.
Yeah, we wanted that world tension low so that we could get Poland and get through that.
So all we wanted to do was just destroy your divisions, and then I just killed.
Our plan hasn't worked perfectly because we also wanted to keep tension low enough that Poland can join allies before it falls.
Yeah, we were like 2% away from that.
This way, all quite a few more countries, including Finland, would join Axis before the war with Soviets.
So if your units didn't get like squad wiped, Bridger, then Poland wouldn't have joined the allies actually. So you should be lucky with that.
So because did that increase tension?
No, because you resend extra units.
Oh, I resend more units. You're right. That was another 2%.
That messed it up.
Yep.
Yeah. That was.
So yeah, it was all part of a map.
I was so happy to see you.
Why don't we rehost it and start it again? Because we clearly have failed in the branding of this epic game of watching over the course of weeks. And I take full partial credit on that.
The perch, doing the perch right now was also beautiful because you were in the perch while we were fighting you, and it was like, oh, good. This is good. This is great.
And Peter, you
we saw
the...
it coming too. I knew it was coming, and as soon as we saw you going down Eastern Claims, we're like, oh shit! And they're gonna try and hit us from two sides.
Hell yeah!
And at that moment, we just started pumping out military factories and moved all our civilians to the bottom, and it still wasn't enough.
Yeah,
it was a couple of days ago. That was pretty good. Well, you were talking about PRC being overpowered, and I was like, no, let them do whatever you want. He was like, no, PRC is too strong. We need to give them some more. I'm like,
no. In our other game, they definitely seem that way, but it's certainly possible that the Axis just didn't play.
Hey,
we changed it up.
You know what we were wondering in the Allies? Now, in the British tree, there's a what you can get to Indian independence. Now, if we got to the Indian independence, would that cancel out the 15% the Raj,
and because they're not a puppet anymore, you mean?
Yeah
could the US do it too, that would be an interesting thing to test because then you're just giving them to the AI, and I mean the AI might send them to their expeditions too. Can you rehost it in a census?
Yeah, sure. I will click done here on the peace treaty.
I don't think you can just exit. I don't think you need to save anything.
Okay, but I think if you want to play like a proper, we need to come
up with a better set of rules
first.
Yeah.
Yeah, do you want to change any of the rules? Otherwise, I'll just do the same thing again.
You want to change the teams up a bit?
Yeah, you might want to.
Team change is also fine.
I want another shot at the USSR. I obviously played pretty crappy, but I learned so much.
But yeah, it looked like it's a little unbalanced because you guys don't look very experienced.
I was just role playing the Soviet Union, okay?
Right, role playing losing all your tanks.
Okay.
In my defense, I was playing the PRC that you really can't do much, especially whenever you took China.
Do we want to take a short break and then come back soon?
Yeah, let's do 5 minutes.
Doesn't have to be gimped.
All right, yeah, because I'd like a cup of coffee. So.
All right, we can have a short break, I guess.
Refresh themselves and think about what adjustments we
might want to
make.
Shall we join the game first?
Sit in your corner and think about what you did wrong.
Deleting those divisions doesn't make things disappear. All it does is add the equipment to my other troops.
Okay, hold
having,
the game,
having
join the game,
an extra
game.
24 right. half-strength divisions isn't going to help at all.
Game is up.
The Germans.
Yeah, that's fine.
All right, there it is.
And don't say the secret password. Yeah, say the secret password. Everybody on stream watching.
Yes, they are.
Yeah, I went through my break screen.
You mean the password wombat?
No, not the wombat!
Oh,
the
darn
combat
it.
Wombat!
Did you just give it away?
Yeah, I'm really happy with the strategy. It's really, really powerful.
Yeah, me too.
No, deleting the divisions doesn't lose you anything. I'm trying to explain this. You don't lose manpower or equipment by deleting them. I was at a deficit in equipment the entire
right,
game.
Right, so I will
if
be
I hadn't deleted them and just
drink,
switched
getting
them
something green, getting something
all
to
that
eat,
is
and
the rest of my
right
units
back.
Would have had less equipment.
So thank guys for watching my first victory in the multiplayer scene, and we'll be back soon.
It's literally no different.